question for all of you this morning. I don't want you to answer it out loud. I just want you to hold the answer in your head after I ask this question. Where are you from? Where are you from? Okay, so now you've got an answer. You're just going to hold on to that answer. I love to ask people this question. I hear all kinds of answers. I'm in Oklahoma. Depending on how far back people let themselves think. If you reach back far enough, if you ask somebody in Oklahoma where they're from and you reach back far enough, you'll land on an answer outside of Oklahoma. So I'm curious right now, how many people, when they got their answer, was it someplace outside of Oklahoma? If you'd raise your hand, that'd be great to see. A lot of you. Great, okay. So you know a lot of this history. Some of this is going to be review for some of you. There were some native peoples who called this land home, but people from what came to be known as the five civilized tribes here in Oklahoma, the Cherokee, the Chickasaw, the Choctaw, the Creek, and the Seminole peoples, they were all forced to relocate here. It was a very difficult journey for their families. There were grandparents and parents and children and babies, which is why we call it, do you know what we call it? The Trail of Tears, right? Because so many people died on the way from their native lands to this land here in Oklahoma. And then many of us with lighter skin or whiter skin, my skin's a little yellow, Marlon calls it olive. Many of us have European origins. We come from the lands across the Atlantic Ocean in Europe. And many of us with darker skin, there are so many different shades of darker skin. Some of us are descendants of people who are, again, forcibly brought to this country and brought to this land here in Oklahoma, forced to be slaves in this land. And then others of us come from Central and South America, or from some islands in the Caribbean or the Indian Oceans or other island nations. My point this morning, though, is that most of us, the vast majority of us, more of us than raised our hands this morning, come from someplace else than here. So we can imagine how hard it must have been to leave everything behind, how hard it was for our ancestors to leave their homes and their friends and their family and their school, all the cultural things that they knew and made them feel at home, how hard it would be to leave all of that behind and hard to learn a new language. So that is nothing compared to a memory I had this week thinking about Thanksgiving and what's happening in our world today. But I do remember when I changed schools. I went to a new school in fourth grade. And I had been in a bilingual school from kindergarten, and the morning was all in French, and the afternoon was in English, but it really was more of a French school than an American school. The way that school was run was more by French people. And I was super embarrassed on my first day of fourth grade in my new American elementary school because I didn't know the Pledge of Allegiance by heart. You can be sure that when I went home, I memorized it really, really quickly right that day. So the next day, I wouldn't have to feel embarrassed or humiliated again. So I'm guessing that most of you know that, and I'm wondering if you could help me just recite it. We'll just stay where we are, but can we recite the Pledge of Allegiance together? You ready? I pledge allegiance to the flag and to the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. Those are really, actually very, very powerful words with a very powerful promise, a promise that I would say we're still trying to fulfill here in the United States today in 2015. Which means that we're really all on a boat together, in a way, heading toward that promise of one nation, indivisible, with liberty, freedom, justice for everybody, as Dorothy tells us on Sunday morning, right? For everybody, because it's not everybody yet. You with me? It's not everybody yet. We're on our way to creating the America we imagine and dream somewhere on that horizon is possible, a land with liberty and justice for all, a land undivided and indivisible. And that depends on us, on the decisions we make today and tomorrow and the day after that and next week. And we don't know how many days it's going to take us to get to that America. But we know it's where we're headed. And we know from all the people who made that journey to get here and suffered hardship and were afraid that it takes patience and it takes courage and it takes trust to keep on heading in that direction toward a land of freedom and justice for all. And you could call all of that combined, you could call it faith. Faith in the promise of what America is supposed to be. So this is a really important journey that we're all on together. And it's especially important today with the global refugee crisis that's happening in the world. You know that there are more people, and there, many of them are women and many of them are children, who are refugees from civil wars or crises in their nations more than ever since World War II. Right now, people are wandering and they're homeless and they're afraid and they're alone and they're hungry. And there's one more thing I want you to know. Do you know that the French, after being attacked last week, they've opened their borders and have said that they're going to welcome 30,000 Syrian refugees. While we here, yeah, it's worth clapping for. While we here in the United States of America, the land where we promise liberty and justice for all, are fighting about welcoming 15,000. And France is a country that fits inside the state of Texas. And there's another reason it's an important story for us to tell in Oklahoma, because you may or may not know this story. I learned it pretty recently, that when times were really tough here in the 1930s, during the Dust Bowl era, when the land got really dry, you may have studied this in school, you guys, and the farms were just blowing away, and people had no way to make a living, and their children were hungry, a lot of people from Oklahoma decided to leave, and they wanted to go west. They wanted to go to California, where there were farms, they were green, and there was plenty of rain. And do you know what the people in California said to the Okies? Do you know what they said? They said, no, we don't want you. Go away. Stay in Oklahoma. You're poor. We don't want to feed your children. You don't belong here. We're doing just fine on our own. And it was the federal government who had to talk to the leaders of the state of California and said, you can't do that. We are one nation, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. You have to let those people who were hungry from Oklahoma come. And they did, and that's how many of the families from this state survived, because they were able to leave and go someplace where the land was fertile and rich. I actually wonder, before I go on, I'm almost done, how many of you have family members who were alive during those times that survived the Dust Bowl era here in Oklahoma? Huh. You look around if you're sitting in the middle of the front. Keep your hands up for a second. So remember, this is what I want you to remember this Thanksgiving week. No matter what you look like, if you live in Oklahoma, there's a really good chance that your ancestors came from someplace else than here. And I hope maybe you'll spend some time this Thanksgiving week with your relatives talking about where your family did come from way back. You might have to reach a little farther back than you're used to reaching them, but find out where your roots are. And be sure to say thank you. Thank you to your ancestors who found their way here. This is where I need your help. Let's say thank you to them.
Thank you.
And thank you to the people who were here when they got here and helped them learn the customs of this place. Let's say thank you to those people who were here and welcomed your ancestors in.
Thank you.
Those are the people who came before us, and we are the people who will determine the future of this nation. We are the ones. So I think I can hear you asking me one last question. Barbara, how many days until we get to that America that we're dreaming of? A few more days. A few more days, one day at a time, one year at a time. We're gonna get there, because I can see it. I can see the promise of freedom and justice and liberty for all. Can you see it? One nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. It's worth the journey.
Thanks for tuning in online. We are so pleased with all the different people who have been tuning in from all over the country and all over the world. If you have a chance to send me an email or connect with me in some way, let me know what you're finding, why you tune in, and what you're getting out of it. I would love to hear from you. And if you get a chance to make a gift to support this ministry, to become a partner, we would love to partner with you and have you be a friend of the church and somebody who is actually supporting us to create this congregation and the world that we're trying to create together. You can be a part of it, and every gift of every amount makes a difference. We really appreciate your support.